The union representing ICE agents accusing Portland, Oregon Mayor Ted Wheeler of creating a zone of terror and lawlessness and claiming he violated the Constitution by ordering police not to come to the aid of ICE employees after Abolish ICE protesters encamped themselves outside the ICE office. The mayor calling that accusation inaccurate and inflammatory. The president of the National ICE Council, Chris Crane, joins me now. Let me ask you, Chris, first of all, I'll preface this by saying we did reach out to the mayor, Mayor Wheeler, to join us, and we have not heard back. But what's your reaction to what he's saying about you guys right now?
Well, it's kind of a little bit of disbelief, but I think it's a lot of political spin coming from Mayor Wheeler right now. The mayor's trying to make the case that there was no need to provide police protection for our employees in that facility, that we had some kind of massive police force that could protect them, when in reality we just had a handful of employees in that building surrounded by hundreds of protesters. They blocked the entrances and the exits. Our folks were trapped in that building. When they did try to leave, protesters surround their cars, damage their cars, threaten their lives. And it's really been a desperate situation for our employees. Protesters even followed them home to their residences, followed them when they went to pick up their kids at daycare, repeatedly threatening their lives. This was not some normal protest where people were out there trying to express their free speech rights in a peaceful manner. This was an absolute siege of an ICE facility. A lot of people don't know this. This really isn't getting covered out in the mainstream media. We lost that building for 10 days, almost 2 weeks. The protesters took control of that building, and these were not normal protesters. These, folks like Antifa, violent militant groups out there coming against our employees, and the mayor refused to provide them protection. Absolutely unacceptable.
Why do you think he's reluctant to give these employees, these ICE employees, the protection they need right now?
It's all about politics. He disagrees with President Trump's policies on immigration, which, by the way, I have to mention here that the protesters were there allegedly to protest ICE's separation of families, when in fact it was the Border Patrol that was given the direction to separate the families down on the border, not our ICE employees, certainly not ICE employees in Portland, Oregon, 1,000 miles away from the border. So the entire thing is kind of nonsensical from the beginning, but it's all about politics. He's never taken the time. We've asked to meet with him. We've yet to have a meeting with him. Like you, we're not really hearing a whole lot back from the mayor at this point. And we're really hoping that moving forward, he will provide our employees with the protection that other citizens in the area have and that we can move past this.
Are you fearful? Are these ICE employees fearful right now? I mean, are there people that are saying, look, I didn't sign up for this?
I don't think our folks are saying that they didn't sign up for this. I mean, I think they're definitely looking for stronger leadership from DHS and ICE on these types of matters. They want to have the proper equipment and the proper training and preparation to deal with this type of event. We are not going to let people like this scare us out of doing our jobs, to include the mayor of Portland. But there is a lot of cause for concern when people are following you back to your home and threatening you and your family, following you to pick up your kids at daycare, trapping you in a building, and you're all alone, and there is no police there to respond and help.
Yeah,
it's definitely a situation of concern.
Chris Crane, thank you so much. Good to have you here today.